So, it's been a while. Look at this hair growth. It's like you probably don't recognize me. I don't recognize myself. But this is straight out of the shower, low dried, you know, late at night. And it's been a while since I posted on here. I use this as my diary, a video diary. And today I want to document something that I want to never forget, or at least a person I never want to forget. And how could you? My friend Danielle, my Breasties girl. I found this group called the Ohio Breasties. The Breasties is where they originated from. And they're this group of young women of survivors, previvors, and it just doesn't matter who you are. If you're affected by cancer and you're a young woman, any person really, we will accept you. I mean, they will accept you. And through them, I have been granted this incredible blessing of a community of women who all get what I'm going through, who yet have different stories, some very similar to mine. And one of the women that I connected with the most and felt that she was like my soul sister was my friend Danielle. And last night, after a long battle with cancer and many stories to tell and Breasties meetups where I was always looking forward to see her and sit next to her and share my wine and appetizers with her and wear hats and funky wigs. She went to heaven to be with God. And boy, do I feel selfish grieving, because she has a family out there that is grieving for worse than life. But I guess it's that psychology in me, that survivor's guilt, because she was such a better person than I was. And I just don't understand why it was her, not me. And the last time I saw her was at our Breasties meetup. She made this joke about, hey, let's make my funeral a Breasties event. I was one of the only ones to laugh. She commented too soon, as to which I looked at her and go, not for me, obviously. I've always found that dark-sided humor, and we have that in common. We were girls that wore wigs all the time and shared the commonality that it wasn't just hair. We both gave up on that at the end. She gave up at the end of her journey and showed who she was, and she empowered me to do that as well. But hey, who doesn't have fun with a wig now and then? She was always the friend that liked the same wine, the girl that I would share my appetizer with because she liked the same stuff as I did. My hat partner, my fabulous fashion, adventurous friend that I got cut short of knowing because of cancer. And I sit here and ask myself, why me? Why did I live and she didn't? I don't know. I saw a post about this saying that the most amazing people, which she was, at times get called back to heaven far too soon because they are that truly special. They really would just belong in heaven, and God needs them. Maybe, no, she was that special. I reflect on her passing as my first true friend to pass away, let alone as the first person I was ever close to die from this fucking bullshit we call cancer. She taught me that I have the option to get help where other people don't, and I get to rather than I have to. And then I stuck with me and carried with me. I took a break from social media. I was diagnosed with PTSD, as you know. Mental health issues affect, God, nearly 50 to 70% of women, depending on what type of mental health issue you want to go into and what you're talking about. What do I do with this? How do I channel this into something that I can do for my life? How do I appreciate the fact that, as she said, she took one for the team? Could have easily been me. Just as easily. That really... as hard as it is to say, sunk into me. And here I am, feeling bad because my life's in shambles, but I survived. How selfish can I be? She did everything she could, and she took one for the team. How dare I sit here and complain? For me, life was harder after cancer. Because that's when everything had time to sink in. Now, it's crunch time. It's time to show everybody what I can do. Besides just be cancer. I want to be something more. I want to honor her memory as the first person that I've been truly close to pass away from this. Sorry for the long video. Most of you have tuned out by now, but like I said, these videos are for me, not for anyone else. But I do appreciate you watching them, and I hope you share. And I hope you gain something from it. If you got an idea of a topic or a question, please let me know. I'm just determined to get more involved and to get back on track with this, so I would love to reach out to many people. Send me some questions. Help me get motivated. Help me find a purpose. Thank you. And I love you all. Rest in peace, Danielle. I know you're up there drinking champagne celebrating. I love you.